Micah Jesse here at Spitzer's Corner in New York City. I'm about to interview one of the biggest up-and-coming groups in pop music, Chester French. Stay tuned. So you were offered a record deal by both Kanye West and Pharrell. How did that come about, and how did you decide to go with Pharrell's label over Kanye?
Well, we were a pretty unusual act as a new artist in the sense that we focused basically almost entirely on the studio. And our goal was to make a great classic album ourselves. We made this record and then started sending it to just a million people. And serendipitously, it got to Kanye and Pharrell and Jermaine Dupri and these folks right around the same time. And they were nice enough to give us this opportunity.
You guys have a very humorous side, clearly. Take a look. Your album, Love the Future, is packaged as a CD case-sized condom. Tell me about that.
Our single, She Loves Everybody, was packaged in a condom because the song goes, she craves affection, so I use protection. So that was the protection part. Our album cover, it's us with a geisha. And this is something we've worked on for like 3 years, so we're super excited to put it out.
Okay, so let's talk about She Loves Everybody, because it's about a girl.
Yeah.
Who was the inspiration for that girl?
It wasn't one girl or another. It was, you know, I mean, we've dealt with scandalous females in the past. They're scandalous guys too, but, you know, the song is from sort of our perspective, so.
I actually heard that you were actually going around hand to hand selling your CDs.
Max and I have been selling CDs on the street for like five years.
But nothing's changing. You're on MTV, but you're still doing it.
We're just right now on tour with Lady Gaga, who's a huge, you know, blockbuster artist. Right. And I mean, you can be the cool guy and go back to your tour bus every night and just chill, which sometimes you want to do, but then you're not building supporters. And you're not using that opportunity to extend your reach and show people what you're about. And so, you know, we do the show and people see it and hopefully enjoy us. And it's just as important that afterward we're out there to meet them and share our music with them. And that's some of the most important work we do.
You've been using Twitter to kind of reach out to your fans. What do you feel about celebrities using Twitter as that kind of almost like mini press releases?
One thing that's obviously changing with the economy of art and entertainment is that you need to provide a constant source of information about what you do or what you're making. I mean, anyone who loves us right now is one of the first. You know, we're not a big band, so, you know, we have a lot of respect and gratitude. Oh, I guess, yeah, we're on MicahJesse.com, so, yeah.
Would you say that you guys have struggled?
Oh, well, I wouldn't say we've struggled. We've been doing this for 5 years, though, and so even though we've only recently sort of come out on the national or international scene.
Small, dude. That's all there is to it. Very small comp.
Confidence?
Comp.
Comp?
Yeah, what's that?
Oh, like our struggle. Yeah, like Hitler's book, Mein Kampf, My Struggle.
Right. Where did the name Chester French come from?
We named ourselves after the sculptor Daniel Chester French, who had been sort of a great American sculptor of boring pieces of artwork. You know, he did like the Lincoln Memorial. You know, he did the John Harvard statue, which is sort of the centerpiece at Harvard. Small seated man. A lot of seated men, basically.
Got it.
And we just thought the name sounded cool. There was no significance.
Were you guys the cool kids in high school, or, I mean, in college, or were you kind of the, I don't know?
So we went to Harvard where everyone's a loser. Yeah.
I don't think you're a loser.
Who are your heroes, each of you?
Abraham Lincoln's pretty dope, and I like the Founding Fathers. I think they're pretty interesting.
I like my parents.
They're really good people.
They're really great people. Seriously.
Musically, I think we look up to folks like Outkast, Beck, Brian Wilson, the Beatles, obviously, classical composers, Chopin, Rachmaninoff.
Some people draw a parallel between you and your band and MGMT. What do you think of that?
We don't think we sound like MGMT or like Vampire Weekend or these other sort of called college bands or prep rock or whatever, but I mean, they're a great band. We were really into their album. We thought it was great, and, you know, I mean, being compared to anyone who's creative and doing cool stuff is always very nice.
When I go out and people say, oh, how was last night? I say, oh my God, it was totes amazeballs. So I'm wondering, what are 10 things that you think are amazeballs?
MicahJesse.com, for sure. We like Prince. I think he's very talented. The photographer, Francesco Carozzini, who did this photo, we think is great. We've been listening to the T-Rex song, Metal Guru, on the bus. Rushka Bergman, who picked out these clothings for us.
You know about?
Okay.
I really like Nerds.
Our mixtape, Shock Jams, Volume 1, Endurance, coming out next week, April 6th. Kilgore, my favorite designer right now in England. Carlo.
So much Googling to do.
This is DA.
And I'm Max.
We are Chester French, and you're rocking with Micah Jesse at MicahJesse.com.